Good morning, dear students. Do you hear me?
Yes, we do.
Okay. I've got some problems with connecting, but as I see now, everything is okay. We are waiting other participants, and after we will start.
Okay.
Good morning again. I see my students now classroom. But in any case, I think we waited enough and we can start. Do you hear me? Is everything okay with the sound?
Yes, we hear you.
Okay. Well, as for our plans for today, the first, I'd like just to explain one more time, because after our previous lecture, I've got questions from Ksenia, and I'd like to explain your behavior, how to prepare tasks for one type of platforms. When today is our last, next moment, this is our last lecture for this discipline called social effects of platforms. And as we agreed last Wednesday, today we will make a draw for defining the order of presentations in May. Have any questions about it?
Okay. No.
As I already said, last Wednesday I've got a question from Ksenia about what are the traditional analogs for social platforms. And what are the traditional companies for it, and what are the problems with what are the possible problems with regulation? And my suggestion, my vision of this moment, that when you, this is the recommendation for all teams from all three groups, when we will prepare this part of analysis about regulations, not only regulations, but if I remember right, when we discussed traditional platforms as a topic, platforms and traditional companies, it will be also suitable when we will analyze these stories, regulation and traditional companies for social platforms. Please pay attention, pay a lot of attention to media companies. Because if we will take the business model the business model for such companies, if we will take the ways when they earn money, where rather similar with social platforms, our social networks. Because, yes, we have a huge amount of users of such platforms, and as for media, we can exclude one category of media for what we, for their services, for their transactions we pay. We say about free media, and they produce the content, content about different spheres of our life. But their main way to earn money, this is advertising. It's really important to understand that players of these markets. We have users for usual media and for social platforms, and we have both companies who pay for advertising. And as if we will take the A the way we will take the part of analysis of social platforms and traditional social platforms and traditional companies, it's also suitable to take media and to compare how it works and what are the possible space for cooperation, for competition, and so on. Because the essence of their activity is the same, they produce the content. But as for, if you remember it from our previous lecture, as for social platforms, they don't produce the content, but they create the space, they create the special possibilities for producing content by their users. And it creates a community. As for regulation, all the biggest part of issues connected to regulation of media, we can also see examples from our country to they are connected they also connected with the content in social networks. And today we also will say about this case with authorities, politicians and media, they press social platforms, social networks, and large owner platforms for their positions, for their activities, and for that reason that they don't want to follow regulation for usual traditional companies like traditional media. This is my recommendation for this case. Is it clear? Okay. I hope it's clear. Well, as for our today's topic, from one side, it will be something like a summary or review of everything that we know about platforms, because when we say about social effects of platforms, we can't exclude economic issues. I hope you know such term like social economic development. But we will try to pay more attention on some social issues connected with platforms functioning, connected with their essence, ownership model, and to understand what are the positive and the negative elements, what are the positive and negative sides of platforms functioning nowadays. Well, I'm trying to. Okay. And do you see the presentation?
Yes, we do.
Okay. I see. So I need to return. Let's see. I've got a comment. Okay. Well, yes, we can return to our presentation and let's start. As I already said, as for our today's topic, it will be like an attempt to assess, to evaluate negative and positive sides of platforms functioning in context of their social audience. And as for our agenda, we will have two parts, positive assessments and negative assessments. I decided to take this order because we will take positive elements, positive sides, positive connotations for platforms, all of them were identified at the beginning of platforms period in world platforms period in world economy, and most of them are connected with economic issues, with economy functioning, but we also can say about some social aspects. In any case, let's try to understand, to analyze positive assessments, positive sides of platforms functioning at the beginning. This is, I think, utopian view on platforms' benefits, but as I already said, as for possibilities of platforms, we try to catch the essence, the philosophy of platforms. All these issues, all these pluses, all these benefits are possible, and I think the popularity of platforms based on this positive, mostly economic aspects. The first one, this is enhance the supply of services, improve productivity and reduce costs. These economic aspects we already discussed during our lectures. It's really a new business model, new way to do business, and partly, but which is, I think, the biggest part of platform's essence. It brings bonuses, it brings results in terms of in terms of economy. Another story, another four elements. This is reduces inefficiencies in existing markets, help to create compelling new markets, increase flexibility in the labor market. As for this case, I will return to it. It mostly connected to social aspects. And be a special help for less developed countries. As for this last point, if I remember right, our two main international economic organizations, International Monetary Fund and World Bank, at the beginning of platform's economy, at the first stages of main platforms functioning, they identifying this new business model, this new way to do business, as bringing huge possibilities for development in less developed countries. Partly it's true, because I don't know, I don't remember, did I give you this example or not. If, for example, to take financial services, I hope you know this mobile operator Vodafone from Great Britain, and he has companies in Africa, in Kenya and Tanzania, Safaricom and Vodacom, if I remember right. and they created payment systems in these countries based on their mobile operators mobile operators infrastructure. We create something like financial platforms, and the name of this system is M-Pesa. You can find information about it on the internet. And yes, it was the reason, one of the reasons of success. This is a huge demand for such services in Africa, in these countries, Kenya and Tanzania, and nearest countries to these two countries. Another reason that it was rather low level of infrastructures development, financial infrastructure development in these countries, and it became one of the main factors why this system, creating this system, was successful. And I think we also can find another examples when representatives, participants from less developed countries through platforms, through global platforms, have a possibility to realize their business or to find a job. Maybe yes, this is one of the way how to develop a country's economy. This is one of main specific features. It's really important to understand who is the platform operator for such cases, because one of the main problems of platforms, and I will repeat it many times for today, this is ownership of platforms operators, private ownership on these platforms from big companies side, huge companies side. But yes, we will discuss it a little bit later. I think just to return the case of labor market, I already started to say about it, that creating platforms, especially global platforms, will improve the development of labor market, labor services, because internet development, you have each worker has the possibility to find a job in, without any geographical restrictions. Creating new markets, yes, it's also possible to identify like a benefit from platforms, because we already discussed it during our previous topics, that platforms, they are not only strong competitors of traditional companies, already existing companies, but they also create new markets, new types of services. And reducing inefficiencies of in existing markets, this is a story. The main point of this story is idle assets. I hope you remember it from our first lectures, because when we try to identify main specific features of platforms, one of these were idle assets. Existing of such assets, this is the one of some, how to say, a strong signal that it's possible to create, to realize platform business model on such money. Yes, I need also to another case connected with platform functioning, and the best way would be to take maybe as example to take financial services, financial platforms. I already described user situation that creating such platforms like cloud lending platforms, for example, crowd investing and maybe realizing the ICO mechanism. The main specific future it's near with either assets. This is removing middlemen or intermediaries from the process, and I'd like to spend some time describing what is the essence of disintermediation process. As I already said, if you look at the definition, it's the removal of intermediaries and economics from a supply chain, or fighting out the middleman in connection with transactions or series of transactions. I think it's the same beginning stage for this process and for platforms creating, for platforms functioning, internet development. High level of internet development in all points of our planet became a reason of huge digital transformation, not only transformation of business models, but transformation in behavior, in customers' behavior, in companies' behavior. And companies, in this context, they have companies may deal with customers directly, for example, via internet. It's the similar like for platforms functioning, development of internet, development of connections between potential customers and resource providers for internet became one of the main reasons of platforms development. As for disintermediation, it may decrease the total cost of servicing customers. Yes, we will exclude some middlemen, some intermediaries from the supply chain. It will reduce the cost, not all costs, but rather big part, and allow the manufacturer to increase profit margins or reduce prices in context and due to the reason of reducing these costs. What else? What are the reasons? What are the, how to say, what are the conditions for this process, for disintermediation process? If we will say about disintermediation initiated by consumers, it's often the result of high market transparency. What does it mean? It means buyers are aware of supply prices direct from the manufacturer, and they want they have a strong desire, and it's suitable for them to exclude middlemen, to exclude intermediaries from the price, from their payments. And you know, as for example, I think rather interesting right example for such function, if we will take last examples, year ago, maybe, yes, or maybe 2 years ago, it was a strong advertising campaign of, sorry, it was a strong advertising campaign on Russian TV about such company, about such mobile application like Joom. Because they construct their advertising campaign that if you will make orders directly from through this app, you will have a possibility to interact, to realize transactions directly directly with manufacturers, excluding all intermediaries. And yes, this is the story, because the biggest part of producers, not only for our country's market, but markets, but for, I think, a lot of countries, many goods, many many goods produced in China, and as for these services, they suggested direct interaction between consumers in our country and manufacturers in China. And I feel starting from it takes last five or six years from platforms function, from function such services like AliExpress, such platform like AliExpress, it became we as consumers started to compare prices on such services like AliExpress, later Joom, with the prices in our shops, in our trade centers, and we can compare, and we've got understanding what is the difference, what are the costs for what are the costs for buying goods in these trade centers. And this is, we can describe it, we can market it like market transparency. High level of market transparency, because if at the, for example, 90s, when you need to you, as for sellers, they made trips to China or maybe Turkey, and to buy to buy goods there for reselling it in our country. Nowadays we need them to do it, because we have a little bit higher level, not little bit, but rather higher level of logistics in these spheres, and it brings clear understanding of the function of this market. Yes, and as for continue to disintermediation, buyers might choose to bypass the middleman, to buy directly from manufacturer and pay less. And buyers can alternatively elect to purchase from wholesalers, sellers. I think yes, if we will take the current situation, we have a choice to go to shop, to go to trade center and to buy some goods, any exact goods, or maybe to make an order for internet. But especially if we will say about clothes, sometimes our decision is to go to trade center, because we need to understand, to taste these products before buying. But as for development of platforms, as for development of platforms business, we started to organize. We understood this problem, and we started to organize trade points, special points for when you can taste this product before you buy it. And one idea about it. Yes, and what else? You will say about disintermediation process. This is business to consumer. Electronic commerce company functions as bridge between buyer and manufacturer. And typical B2C supply chain is composed of supplier, manufacturer, wholesaler, retailer, and buyer. As for essence of disintermediation, we try to exclude the middle blocks in this chain. Sometimes, yes, this is excluding manufacturers. It's not a mistake that manufacturer is the second. The main story is to organize direct interaction between suppliers and buyers to exclude all these additional points and to reduce costs and costs and price. Well, this is, as I already said, we will say about positive sides of platform function. We are mostly connected with economic aspects. Maybe yes, we can try to take some examples from our industries. We already said about labor services, about labor market, and influence of platforms on this market and development of this market. What about other platforms? Yes, it's really important to understand that sometimes when we say about creating platforms and this disintermediation process, sometimes in the biggest part of industries, we can, especially goods and services, what else? Financial services. If we take the story of the storm, disintermediation starts from financial sector, and starting from dreams of removing banks. It's also true for what other services. Yes, the main field for it, which is goods and services and financial services, which is directly for, exactly for transaction types of platforms. But from another side, you will say, you will take the case of creating platforms of existing platforms. We can identify such companies, platforms companies, like intermediaries, because as example, we can take another sectors like transport and delivery, the essence of platforms function in these spheres, transport and delivery and others. Yes, I think, and yes, as for hospitality, as for tourism, functioning of platforms, this is matching, creating the space for matching potential customers and resource owners. For example, we take taxi services like Uber, or for example, such services like Airbnb, clients, the essence of function of such platforms is intermediation, connection, creating connections between consumers and resource providers. It's also true for labor services, because for labor platforms, because development of such platforms brings the possibility to find job in any geographical location of our planet, and it was a real decision. And we also just said about it that it changed. This is a positive element, positive side, that it changed the labor market. But we also need to say that it will have some negative aspects, but we will discuss it later in the second half of our today's topic. Well, as for positive assessment, is everything clear? Have you any questions? Because this is the time, I think, for break. And because next part, it will be larger, because we can say about a lot of negative aspects of platforms function. If I remember right, we didn't discuss it. We started to discuss it last lecture, but as for the whole one of our course, it was based on identifying the advantages of platforms, the very strong sides. But we also need to pay attention to negative elements of platforms function, and it will be the second part of our today's last lecture discipline. Have you any questions?
Everything was clear enough, personally for me.
Okay, I hope this is true for all participants of our today's lecture. Well, I see that this is 12 p.m. and my suggestion to make 30 minutes break. We will continue at 12:30.
Sorry, I would like to ask about our seminars. Do we have the order now or not yet?
Sorry, what do you mean order?
The list of the groups, the topics, who goes the first and second?
Your question is about schedule, isn't so?
Yes, schedule.
Yes. As I already said, I identified it, I said about it at the beginning of today's lecture. We will make a draw at the end of our lecture, because I remember about it. I prepared my cap, I prepared sticks for each team, and yes, we will do it at the end of our lecture. I will after it, I will send information to our seminars leader, to Ivan and Georgi. We will identify all these elements as we agreed last lecture. Well,
okay. We will continue at 12:30. Will
yes,
we?
I'm okay. Writing it in chat, and you can see. Yes, we will continue for 30 minutes.
Okay. Thank you.
Good afternoon, dear students. Sorry for the delay. I checked information about world's largest companies. because it was I will show you this moment. It's really interesting to see the changes in top 10 world largest companies, who are the leaders, what about companies with platforms, business model. We will discuss it in the second part, in this part of our today lecture. Well, as I already said, as for the second part, we will say about negative assessments, about negative positions of representatives of different parts in the world, about politicians and the media, about platforms. Why it's negative? What are the problems with platforms function? I hope that after the first part, you catch the idea. What are the main positive elements of platform function, how it works, why the platforms are so popular. But we also need to say about the problems. And if you remember this moment from our previous lecture, the beginning of process, yes, the beginning of process of platforms analysis. If we will try to identify periods of platforms developments, platforms history, at the early stages, the early years, platforms function faced with really positive assessments of their functioning, of their existing. It was really popular, but due to the period of development, due to the reason of getting or due to the reason of existing large platforms with private ownership, we faced with negative positions about platforms functioning, about the problems with their function. And nowadays, I'd like to say that we have something like hard discussion about the future of platforms, about their developments, especially also about platform with private like element of private ownership. But let's move to various arguments against platforms. The first, they contribute to technological unemployment, and a little bit later in this part, we will try to understand what is the essence of technological unemployment and why platforms contribute to it. But I hope you I'm not sure that. But maybe yes, if I remember right, all students from our minor are from economic and management related bachelor programs. In any case, you have understanding, preliminary understanding what is technological unemployment. Another story, this is more social story, and this is the position of different politicians in different countries, that they accelerate the replacement of traditional jobs with precarious forms of employment, much less labor protection. And if you remember from our topic, from the first half of our discipline, platform work, we partly discussed this moment that yes, from if we will take the positive assessment, platforms create new job places. They make it easier to find a job, non-usual job, but it's a possibility to find a job, especially for countries, for regions with problems with job places. But from another part, as for forms, as for types of these new job places, these new jobs, we face problems because it doesn't regulate by usual laws and norms, and in many countries, governments started to analyze how to regulate these forms of jobs, which forms of workplaces, what to do. Another story, this is we may contribute to declining tax revenues, because you remember I gave you this example as for previous week meeting that platforms participants, it's possible and sometimes it's usual in their behavior that they don't want to pay taxes because they needn't to follow all regulatory rules in their industries. For example, we can take hotels, we can take rent apartments, because they haven't so strong control, and governments haven't understanding how to control, because if we all our usual already existing systems of control doing business in different countries based on usual and traditional forms of business. As for these norms and laws for control or procedures for control, they are not suitable for platforms function. And this is a real problem, not only the economic problem, but social too. And another element, I hope you understand this idea, with excessive use of platforms can be psychologically damaging and corrosive to communities. Yes, this is a real problem nowadays. I remembered one picture and one popular phrase about it. The first phrase was the person answered that he or she has different accounts, for example, Facebook, Instagram, and another social networks. And yes, he or she said that yes, I have such account like real life, but I totally haven't time for filling this account. And yes, this is a real problem nowadays, and a lot of sociologists and psychologists identifying this problem and try to suggest decisions for it. Another story with these pictures and with this connotations to my answer on Xenia's question, because the picture is comparing consists of two parts. The first, this is persons on near the wall, and all of them read the newspaper, and this is the beginning of 20th century. And nowadays, the same picture, but all use their smartphones for reading news from social networks. This is, to my unfortunately, I haven't enough time to find this picture, but yes, this is a real problem, especially connected with social networks, but also it's also we can say about it about other platforms, because for example, for goods and services, it becomes usual for us to make orders through internet, but it dramatically changed our consumers' behavior, and sometimes, especially if we say about non-quality goods, it becomes a problem because you haven't any possibilities to taste, to test this good before you buy it, and it becomes a problem for regulations. For any regulations, how to identify what is a big place in this story. Well, as for other stories, as other negative assessments connected with some social aspects, it's really discussive statements, because how to understand that they can increase inequality, but I think we can start to save this position. We can start from a functioning of large private ownership companies. If you haven't possibility to participate, if you don't follow their rules for their platforms, you haven't access to all benefits from these platforms. I remember an example when I was a student. It was really I had a period when for me it was enough to use our social more than enough to use our social network contacts. I deleted my account, and I faced with real problem that whole news about such intellectual game, what were when all news about it spread through this social network. And what to do? I'd like to get information about tournaments, about games, but for it I need to return to this social network. And it was really interesting and unusual when I faced with this problem. But if for example, we will take nowadays, there are a lot of cases when not only problems with hobby, like in my example, but problems with doing business, it's more suitable to use social networks when follow classical way and to create own site. A lot of businesses follow this way. Sometimes they just to create account on Instagram, and they decided that it's enough for developing their business. They can reproduce patterns of racism. Well, it's really painful and interesting moment connected with platforms functioning, especially if we will say about social platforms and their content. We already said about the story that as for platforms like a media, they don't produce content, but they try to regulate it. And some of my friends, for example, faced with new rules or these regulations, for example, in Facebook or maybe Instagram. And yes, as for this way of producing content, then the content, the news, the information produced not by journalists, but usual users without any checking system. Maybe it's from one side, it's right, because even if we will say about our official media, yes, I have a strong sense that I don't see the whole picture of any event if I will try to get information about it, for example, from TV programs. But as for producing this content for social networks, sometimes it also needs to understand that it can damage it can become a problem or painful information for some groups, and maybe if you will say about rules of such platforms, yes, we try to regulate, but as for this regulation, it damage to other communities, to other parts of users. What to do? And if we will say about problems connected with we will say about negative assessments connected with platforms, especially social platforms. They became strong players in media market in, I think, all countries. And it's a real problem how to regulate. Another story, they have a negative impact on the environment. Just an easy example of it, which is drivers of Uber services, because before creating these services, before creating these platforms, we will take example of usual taxi services, traditional taxi services. They have some limitations. They had strong limitations for their functionings, because the function of such traditional services, the base of function, this is number of cars in these services. But when we move to platforms, transport platforms, when all usual drivers can participate in such platforms in producing such services, it really became a problem for environment, because I think in our city, in other big cities like Moscow, for example, we faced that we have more and more cars each day, and what to do with it. We have problems with traffic jam, we have ecological problems. This is just one example, and I think it's for other industries, we can also find such examples. For example, take financial platforms and blockchain technology at the early stages of story connected with cryptocurrencies, it takes a lot of and it costs a lot of energy to produce one new Bitcoin, and it damages environment. Well, as I said, we are returning to technological unemployment, and the definition it's the loss of jobs caused by technological change. And this is a key type of structural unemployment. What are the technological changes? Two main types, you know, we say about technological unemployment. And I think we can identify such examples, technological waves in our history, in history of world economy. Two main types: mechanical muscle machines, or more efficient mechanical mind processes, automation, and human roles in these processes are minimal. World economy history started from mechanical muscle machines, but nowadays, in current time, we faced more and more with mechanical mind processes. And in another part of this second half of lecture, we'll say about another problem connected with such technologies, such technological changes, about it will be about artificial intelligence elements in platforms function, what are the difficulties, what are the problems which we can face in this situation. But as example, displacement of repair pressures by self-service tools, this is just one example. I think we can take a lot of examples from different spheres. When I gave you the lecture, read you the lecture about financial platforms, I also gave examples with banks are moving from call centers to using robots, to using special programs which try to answer our questions. As for other countries, they're not so successful right now, but I think two or three years we will replace all call centers or usual operators, and it will be real example, marked example of such technological unemployment, such technological change in this sphere, in financial services. Another story connected with taxi services and cars without drivers. I think through maybe 5 years it will be very big part of taxi services will be without drivers. And yes, it will be reason of another reason of technological another case another example of technological immigration. Well, another story connected with negative assessment in platform economy and platforms functioning connected with, as I already said, with the types of these platforms. Two polar types of platforms, because I've analyzed some articles in preparing this lecture, and if the one side, and you remember all points connected with positive assessments, all these elements, if to take positive to take po positive assessments, connected with platform cooperativism. Yes, because as for such platforms, we will remind what is the essence of it. As for such platforms, they something like fair platforms, where platforms for their users, and they really benefit. They really benefit to decisions of different platforms. But as for such platforms, I think you don't remember the names of these platforms. This is the small one of the smallest part of platforms in the world. We have another strong and big player, large privately owned platforms. And as for all negative assessments connected with platforms, we are mostly about large privately owned platforms. What are the cases connected? What are the statements? Most of the widely used platforms are owned by private sector. It means that it's really hard to understand. We discussed it last Wednesday, how to regulate it. Because from one side, we have a company and the position of this company, we are just information service. Yes, we organize our business, but we realize platform business model, we match consumers and resource providers, and we haven't any responsibilities for their transactions. But from another side, such platforms became the largest market players in different industries. And I prepared some statistics, as I already said. I already marked this moment that 7 of ten most valuable companies globally are now based on platform business model. And here you can see what was the development last 10, 12 years. At the end of the first decade of the 21st century, the main companies, and you can see only one of them we can identify like using platform business model, partly using it was Microsoft or other companies connected with raw materials, raw resources, with oil, and the same spheres. And through 10 years, what we can see, 7 of 10 companies used the platform model, platform business model. And as for these companies, top six companies, top six and seven among 10 largest companies use platform business models. And yes, they became really large, big players in the world economy. I've tried to check, as I said, to check the information, what is the situation right now, because the 2018, this is pre-pandemic year, 2019, this is pre-pandemic year. And what is the situation right now after in the period of in pandemic period? This is the numbers of this is the list of 10 biggest companies, largest companies in the world in 2020. You know, but we haven't any huge changes in this list of top 10. Maybe as for Saudi Aramco, the reason of the first place, because this company made IPO at the end in 2019, not at the end of this year, but in the spring of 2019, and this is the reason why this company took the first place. But all other companies are the same, like it was in previous slide. And we can see that as for we can also identify that some companies of JP Morgan Chase changed. JP Morgan lost their place in top 10. This is the reason why all main negative assessments connected. One of the reasons why all main negative assessments of platforms of platform economy also connected with large privately owned companies. On platforms, because this is one story. We will take platform cooperatives and your company. Yes. I do just to remind you this information. When some users, different types of users, without any rights, special rights, without any assets, without any brands, try to develop their platforms for their working and so on. I've put example. I remind you the example: Airbnb and Fairmondo and etc. We also Green Taxi. We already identified such platforms. But as for such type of platforms, this is the smallest part of platform economy, and they haven't so strong influence on world economy like large privately owned platforms. Across the world, the large privately owned platforms were subject to increasing questioning about their expanding role and responsibilities. Last Wednesday, we already started to say about it when we discussed some possible regulations, and as for today, as for today's lecture, it will be something called partly repeated by the story. As for USA, marked change of attitudes towards online platforms, triggered by their share size and power. This is one of main question, one of the strongest discussion in US, what to do with such platforms, because it's really hard to control. It's really hard to put. I hope you remember the story when European European Union tried to produce some laws, try to create some laws and to realize some laws about control of such platforms functioning. And this is the same picture in the USA. There are some number of reasons why not only sheer size and power, but some other reasons, some other cases became the reason, became the catalyst for it. One of the main arguments to break up the large tech companies. I think such companies don't agree with this position, but not only in USA, in China, we have the same situation. At the first, several of the larger US-owned platforms were already banned. You remember it from our previous lecture that China protects the internal market, and as for government, government plays the key role in these processes. They try to protect it from everybody. Another case connected with China, and I think a couple of weeks ago, maybe a week ago, I heard this news with focus on their biggest homegrown platforms. You remember these platforms, I'd like to return. As for China, Alibaba, and Tencent, two biggest platforms companies in China, and they try to regulate it. They try to decrease their power. And as for these two companies, I think I hope you know that they have one founder, Jack Ma, and last week, if I remember right, I've heard the news that China's government wants to take Tencent to make it a state company, and it was also the story with a couple of months ago with Tencent IPOs, because if this company realizes this IPO, maybe they became the second world largest company, but China's government stopped this process, and now China's government wants to take Tencent to make the whole business to make it state fund. This is Chinese way how to regulate platforms. We already discussed it, but as for their policy in context of platforms, it's rather hard and strict policy for platforms functioning. As for our country, at the end of the previous year, our government passed a law that would allow large fines to be levied against platform companies for various reasons, including if they essentially Russian citizens. This is more the case for social platforms, social networks. Yes, for such companies, it can become a trouble if they will not follow Russian law in our country. But you know, I didn't put this example in this presentation, but I think 2 or 3 weeks ago, I also read the article about the situation in India. It was also really a hard struggle between Indian's government and big platforms, largest platforms, especially Americans. Platforms companies in this country, and government won in this struggle because these companies, American companies, didn't want to lose such market with more than 1 billion of population. Each country, especially big countries, try to find their own way how to regulate platforms, how to eliminate their negative effects, negative social effects. And this is really interesting, and to see, try to understand the picture, what will be the result. Because it's also it was the situation in U.S. We have something like waves in questions, in discussions of platforms regulations, what to do with such big companies, with these American platforms, and now this is the down of, I think, the bottom maybe, the part of this wave. But I think that new start of new wave development of this wave, it's not so far from nowadays. Well, as I already said, another case, I said it in terms of technological unemployment, but we also need to discuss it. Maybe you remember what we partly said about these mechanisms, about this essence of platform functions in terms of attempts of European Union regulation of platforms, because they asked to open all these mechanisms for understanding how it works and what it is, but what they give possibilities for fair competition. But in any case, we need to say that we have some additional concerns that have been arise due to increasing the role of artificial intelligence in platforms functioning. Because some scientists, and it's rather big part of scientists, argue that artificial intelligence is black box and often lacks explainability. And if you take as example platforms, they the motivation, the arguments of with scientists that even creators of this artificial intelligence mechanisms, they don't know the final result. They can't identify how it will work. And they said well, this is a real problem. This is a real disadvantage to delegate platforms, mechanisms, mechanism for regulations of platforms functioning to artificial intelligence. In continuation of their explanations, they say that platforms can be artificial intelligence and platform can be criticized as bias and exploitative. Sorry. And as for this exploitation arising from relationships between algorithms and platform workers, it's really when we say about such platforms, about their functioning and platforms behavior with artificial intelligence, it's really hard to understand how it works. What are the decisions of this artificial intelligence? And there are a lot of worries about it. Is it right to delegate these mechanisms to delegate this rights to artificial intelligence? Behavioral psychology tactics adapted to algorithmic management and information asymmetrias enabling soft control. I think it's really interesting because we partly discussed it when say about not only regulations but the essence of platform economy. But when some artificial intelligence mechanism try to identify and try to identify what to suggest to users, to workers, to customers, it will be really hard to change the picture that to persuade this mechanism that now, for example, you need to find another item, goods, and or service. You want to change your behavior patterns of your behavior, and as for this story, I think yes, such worries connected with using artificial intelligence with the functioning of this mechanism. In terms of platforms function, in context of platforms function, it becomes a real problem for platforms, for world economy, for regulations of such platforms, and I don't know, maybe. With the decision of break up large private learning platforms, it will make it will make a decision about removing this mechanism. But maybe not. I don't know what will be the future. Now we are in a nice position that we can see the history of platform economy and try to understand try to predict the future to make our own focuses. And as a conclusion, despite all this criticism from media figures and politicians, the large privately owned platforms tended to remain widely popular among ordinary consumers. And I think this, how to say, economic and partly social, economic and social benefits will help in platform functioning and development. But we don't know what will be in future with what problems and barriers we will face in platforms development. What will be the future? Well, I think that's all we will say about lectures. Have you any questions?
Thank you. I believe everything was understandable. So,
thank you,
Nikolai. Well, yes, I hope that it was understandable for all participants, all 10 participants of our last lecture. And as I promised, in any case, when you will prepare this part of task based on this material, try to do it in the same way what are the positive and negative social effects of platform's function of your platforms. It will be, I think, rather continuation of the previous part connected with regulations. Maybe you can change right now. I think that it's possible to change the order. The first to analyze the negative and positive social effects of platforms, of your platform's functioning. And the next step will be to analyze the regulations. But maybe you can save the order based on our lectures order. It's up to you. In any case, please try to analyze and try to identify, and me and my colleagues, we will await results of your analysis. We will be happy to discuss. We will be happy to hear your point of view, but certainly with arguments of your point of view. Well, I think we can move to the draw. We need to open. Excuse me, do you see my screen? Because
we do.
Okay, do you see this file?
Yes.
Okay. Well, as for beginning of this page, you can see our schedule results of draw for the third model. And I've identified the dates and the time for our draw, for order, for our schedule in the fourth model. We will have three meetings after holidays, at least 10 days holidays. And our last seminars will be the 26th of May. What I'd like to say, I don't know, do you know it or not, but the date of exam, this is the 16th of June. But if you remember rules of our discipline, if you will agree with innovative grade, your grade for seminars, you need to come to exam and to pass. Only in the case that you are, don't agree with your mark, your grade, you want to do it to make it higher, you can go to exam and try to pass. I don't know about, I'm not sure about the form, but maybe it would be possible to organize something like teams exam for if the whole team or team's members will not agree with such mark and with grade, and you will get an additional task for preparing it. But in any case, now we need to identify our schedule for May's meetings, and only after results, after collecting all results, no groups, we will see the picture, and we will have understanding, does anybody will go to exam or not. Yes. Do you see my cap?
Yes.
Because I don't see yes. a red line, and I haven't understanding about how to say about demonstrating of my screen. What do you see? Well, as for a third module, the last team, the last team which presented results of their analysis, were social platforms. And as for today, as for our draw, I decided that we will identify the place for social platforms at the first stage. It means that now I'm opening the result, and the result is 2. It means that social platforms will present results at the 19th of May. And what about the openings? As for the openings, the openings will be financial services and groups. If I understand, yes, groups. Okay. We are identifying the first position. Well, as for financial services, as for financial services, yes, we'll do the same, we'll do the first. Your course is the first. It means that you will present it again in the last day. And as for your openings, transport and delivery. And and groups too. Yes. Okay, goods. What about you? Number 3. This is the same to do. Okay, and as for your opponents, this is transport and delivery. Munitions, right, and travel services. Okay, two places, the first and the last, two positions, transport and delivery. Okay, you will be the fifth one. And as for your opponents, it will be goods. No, not goods. It will be railway services. Yes, railway services. And social customers. And as for first place, like it was at the previous module, again, labor services. Because for your opponents, it will be financial services. And social platforms. Well, you've done it. Now you can see our schedule for the first module for May's meetings. We started the 12th of May. We will start again from labor services. I don't know what is better. Maybe it's not so comfortable to be the first one, but sometimes, especially for labor services, we need to participate in seminars, but in last seminars, but I see that opponents for each of our seminars. They have been opponents for each of our seminars. Have any questions about it? I will send this information to colleagues. They will follow the schedule. But in any case, please try to make print screen. For saving. As for my seminars group, as it was in previous module, I will send you the schedule, because you remember we have our own file with results, with Teams list and so on. Well, what about questions from your side?
No questions.
Okay. Well, it means that's all for today. And I'd like to thank you very much for your attention. Thank you very much for attention of this 10 persons. I hope it was interesting and useful.
It was. Thank you.
Well, and I'd like to wish you nice May holidays. Be healthy. This is the main moment, and see you in May.
See you. Thank you. Have a great time.
Goodbye.
Thank you.
Bye.
Goodbye.